To be absolutely honest, I don't think it's a very rare thing to be walking around with these mojos inside us. I see, you know, most people at one time or another, you know, acting outside their personality. And the thing about a mojo is that it's desperate to re-experience the physical body. I mean, mojos want to cling on to the physical plane, and the reason they want to stay here is because they want to experience strong emotions, they want to experience sex, they want to experience any kind of strong emotion to give them, if you like, some kind of sustenance and some kind of form of entertainment. There is nothing else for them to do. Most of us are of a good disposition, and it's very difficult for these things to actually get a grip on us. However, there is an interesting photograph from Australia of these two childlike hands gripping onto a man while he's getting drunk. He's having a good old drink. And alcohol, many psychics have told me, is one of these drugs which really, really oils the wheels, if you like, and allows people to drop down into their lower self, and they find themselves, you know, pub crawling in these dirty old watering holes, bad bars and this kind of thing. And in cities, there's an infestation of these lost souls. And it's when somebody is inebriated that you can often get a really bad situation where not only one, but maybe two, maybe three of these mojos have dropped their way into the person's chakra system, whatever you want to call it. What unfolds then is sometimes a pretty serious story. It can get to the point where we have multiple personalities within one person. And you can have a situation where the mojos are competing for, you know, the person's waking hours. And the mojos can speak directly to that person, and people can, you know, start to think that they're going mad. If we then look at very extreme cases where a mojo has maybe been resident in somebody for, you know, 20 or 30 years, that mojo takes the path of least resistance in terms of its manipulation of physical matter. Ideally, that mojo wants its own body again. It's a lost spirit. It did have a body at one time, and its main goal is it wants to have another body. And what can happen is that small organisms in the body, and the smallest organisms that we find in the human body are viruses and bacteria. You can have a situation where these bacterial cells in the gut are manipulated, and shamans in South America who do what is known as psychic surgery claim to be able to cut out of people's abdomens these worm-like structures, and these are objects that have been sort of knitted or woven together using bile, detritus, bacteria, and plaque in the digestive system.
before you do it through the net. I don't